Hi Aquarius, that's too many cards. This is your reading for the 23rd to the 29th of August. And I'm using the Titanium Fortune cards, which are also known as the Lenormand cards. And we are going into Virgo and also into a new phase of the moon, and as we have the full moon. So again, a big energy shift, slower, gentler with Virgo, more down to earth. So here we go. This is your reading, and thank you very much for your subscribes, your likes and your subscriptions. Remember, if you hit on subscribe and the bell on all, you'll be notified, but you have to also give YouTube permission in your device and in YouTube channel. Okay, and you will save the videos and you can always look back at them. Okay, you come in with the key, and we all know what the key means. It's very simple. If you want to learn Lenormand, I'm willing to teach you. Go and have a look at the website and have a look what the choices of readings are as well. Also, this is a very basic Lenormand card. It's so sweet and easy to read. You've got the meanings of the pictures, and then if you want to go on to the next step, you can do the numerology and the cartomancy. So it's an easy way to get to know the Lenormand. And this book is quite diverse and detailed. Just look at what you get. You get the dog, and you get detailed, you get colored pictures. I will do a review on this deck shortly, and then you can have a look at all the pictures. Well, the key means you hold the key, and we never forget that. You hold the key, you make the decisions. You make the choice on your life path. Okay, now that said, sorry if I was far away, I forgot my microphone. As I'm using microphones now, so that it's nice and loud and clear, and I just forgot. I just put it behind the laptop because I had to clear the table to shake the cards. So the cards are really well shaken, and here you are. You've got the star. You're the only one that had the star from this deck, if I remember correctly. You've got a very lovely, diverse reading. You also have the Hierophant, so you might decide to go and study. You could study Lenormand, spirituality, or just your own faith, dig deeper into the Bible, or your own book. That can be the, I forgot the name now. Well, anyway, your religious book from whatever faith, okay? I forgot the name of the Jewish book and the Muslim book, and I do have them both because I love mystical stories, I love history, I love culture. You learn so much, and also I like to read up on faiths. Every single faith is different, and yet it boils down to the same thing, just one ultimate power with a different name in each belief. So that's why I respect beliefs and cultures and history, and I find them very intriguing. Not only that, but also the people of those countries and cultures. So you could be diving into books, you could be learning something, as the Hierophant is a head of an institution, the church in this case, but it does represent government institutions like municipalities, hospitals, schools, universities, anything like that. Also, he represents judges, lawyers, advocates, anybody that works for an institution. So you might be seeking guidance from a teacher, a professor, a doctor, or another form of professional. He also resembles the father figure, a mature man with life experience and wisdom. So you could be seeking advice from your father or uncle or grandfather or a professional. That's the overall energy. And remember, time is man-made. So if you want a complete picture, then have a look at your rising sign and your moon sign, as this reading also represents those signs beside the sun sign. You come in with the Four of Clover, so you have luck in the beginning of the week and the end of the week. Now, we all know that the star represents navigation, wishes, goals. So you might be navigating by the stars, manifesting visualization in the stars or at full moon periods, and you are navigating your way. You've chosen your way. This is the quick read that I would do for a 1 minute reading every day that I do on TikTok and YouTube. Luck is definitely on your side. You decide when you want to take off and sail. But the ship means you could be traveling, you could be crossing water, you could be going on holiday, you could be moving home. You might even be immigrating, going overseas, or you might be crossing water, like in big countries like Russia or America, some parts of Europe. You might be crossing water to get to another country, and you might be going on holiday in that country, depending on the regulations of the COVID rules in your country or vicinity, region. Okay, you make the choices. This is the crossroads representing choices, decisions. You will be making your decisions that will bring success and fulfillment to dreams and goals. Beautiful. Now, you've also got the Ace of Wands underneath the clover, and that means you could be starting a new activity or creation, because it stands for action, creativity. So you might start a new hobby, or you might have a new passion. This could be with a Taurus, because the Hierophant represents Taurus, and that's the only person I can see in your reading. But remember, this is a general reading, so it can be anybody. And remember, it could be a person that works for a municipality or an institution. So you could be starting a new relationship, passion, with a fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. We are still a few days in Leo, so it could happen within the next few days between now and the 22nd, 23rd. And this could be a long-lasting relationship, because he's also the priest, but he also represents municipal or governmental institutions. So it could be the justice of the peace. You could be getting married. For those that have just started this new passion, this could turn into a fully fledged relationship, so long you know each other's boundaries. And you can see that there's two hands open to receive, and there's a ribbon, and it looks like it's around one wrist, and that's tying the knot, literally, as a symbol. In some beliefs, they tie ribbons or a cloth around each other's arms in the symbol of unity, like the infinity knot. Okay, but it's not tied up, fixed, tied up. So you could be tying the knot. I think that's where the saying comes from as well, tying the knot. So this passion could turn into a long-term relationship. Know each other's boundaries, because passion doesn't last. Make sure that you know each other's boundaries. Let each other know what your boundaries are, so that you don't get burnt out, and that this relationship can grow steady but slow and going with the flow. Your cup runneth over. Okay, you've got the Ace of Cups, so you could be getting married to a gem, Cancer, Scorpio, or a Pisces, or there could be a one coming in. Those are the prominent people, like Taurus, all the water signs, all the fire signs. So those are around you. Now, the cups also stand for passion. So there is a lot of passion this week. So for those that are already hooked up, new passion could be firing up since you've got the Ace of Wands and the Ace of Cups. So this little flame could be re-lighted in an existing partnership or marriage. You might have felt left out, but you had to make choices or decisions. And that's why this fire could ignite again into passion, not just love, boring, sustainable patterns. There might be a different pattern. You might be buying a boat, you might be sailing, you might be doing a new hobby, like I said, being creative, just taking quality time out for you with no restrictions, because there's no boundaries. So on water, you can cross water, but whether you will get into the harbor of another country, that is yet to be seen. Like I said, the COVID restrictions. But if you do have your own ship and you do sail from place to place, you can remain on board and be isolated. That is just the beauty of a ship. I've had a boat. And you can stay on board and be self-sufficient, and you can really have quality time with the people on board. So no worries. If you go on board with six people, let's say that, then it will be regarded as a family unit, because it might take you a week or a week and a half or 2 weeks to cross the gigantic Atlantic Ocean or the Pacific Ocean. Just think of it. Or you could be going for a cruise. The decisions are there for you. You hold the key. Are you going to be the captain of your own boat? Because that is also what it represents, by making your own decisions and guiding or navigating your way to your goal or wish. But make sure it's yours and your partner's. So the balance will be there. You might feel isolated since you've got the Five of Pentacles here, from a family or from a group of friends at work or general. Or perhaps you might want to feel isolated and take out that quality time. So talk to your partner if you have one, or potential partner. Remember, you can always ask help, because this represents institutions, also governmental institutions, if you have money worries, because that is what the Five of Pentacles also mean, that you are trying to balance and getting out of a rut hole or a difficult time financially. You can ask for financial support from institutions. Perhaps you're a bit in between jobs, so go to the job center and ask them to reschool you if you haven't got enough money to get a study done or a project. You've got a chance here, so be creative. Go forth and ask for financial help whilst you're studying and working. Awesome. There will be celebrations, because your wish is coming true if you take action and you make the decision to do that. Doesn't matter in what, you will have success. And you will gain your balance back. Why? Not just because I've got the card holding balance, but because you're taking action. You're taking charge of your own life and your own course. You are going with your flow to your northern note, and you are in the spotlight. So you will be getting recognition, and you are being seen. So perhaps you won't feel so alone once you join a new group or with a new partner, if you haven't got one, or if you take a new path or a new course with your relationship. It could be reunited, re-enlightened, the fire, the passion. boom, and you will find the balance between love and passion. 1 and 9, as you've got 19, becomes 10. There is an ending to imbalance. Balance will be returned. This could be with the full moon. Right. Now, what you also have is shine on like a diamond. You are. Remember, you're a gem. Everybody is a gem in their own right. So reach for the sky and fly. Reach for those stars. And now I've got a song coming into my head. Shine on like a diamond. And I think it's either Supertramp or Pink Floyd. Beautiful song that. I love the Pink Floyd and Supertramp. And then you've got glass half full. Don't look at half empty. Look at what you've got and don't look at what you don't have. Go forth and get it. Take a page out of the book of the fire signs. Keep your chin up and see things in a positive light. But yet, this is my words, realistic. Don't build any castles in the sky. Look up and see and be positive. Boom, you hold the key. I hope you have enjoyed this reading and I hope you will have a wonderful week and reach out for the sky and fly. Spread your wings. You can do it in any situation, in general life, in relationships or career. I believe in you. If I believe in you, you should believe in yourself. Take care and be great and shine like that star. Until next time, ciao, ciao.